Good morning.
Good morning. Get the party, the party, the party, the party, the party,
the party, the party, the
party, the party, the party, the party, the party, the party, the party, the party, the party, the party, the party, the party, the party, the party,
I know that.
How do you know?
Because we have a song for everything.
Fine.
What were you asking me?
What?
You were asking me something.
Can you take your clothes off?
You were asking me that. You were asking me about food.
Oh.
Because we're bougie.
You want to eat outside because it's beautiful?
So, good morning. We actually got room service sent to our room today, and that's what he was asking me for. And I don't want to eat outside because I'm a little pansy, and I'm going to be freezing my nuts off, so I probably won't eat outside.
What if you just wear a jacket?
There's not enough. I didn't bring my snow wardrobe, Papa.
What? There's no snow.
I know, but it's the ocean. It's cold as fuck.
No, it's not.
What's the difference between eating in here and looking at it and eating out there and looking at it?
You don't feel it.
How about you eat outside, I eat in here?
No, Mom.
And we're both right next to the glass.
That is a divorce breakfast. If you don't want to, we could just eat in here. Could you eat in here like losers? I don't care.
I want to be a loser. Finally docked on land, and I was just mentioning to you.
Yeah.
I was literally just telling you that I really don't like being on boats. And what was your rebuttal, or your reply, not even a rebuttal?
Well, my reply was, so I don't know if I would go on a cruise again, because I didn't really, it's not that I'm having a horrible time, I just feel like it's not really my thing. But I'm really glad that I went on this boat because I learned something new about myself that I otherwise wouldn't have been able to, which is if I would get seasick on a boat that size. And spending 24 hours on a boat rocking away like crazy.
Don't do that. I'm already getting seasick.
Rocking away like crazy. It did make me feel kind of funny, but I didn't get seasick at all. So I'm like, oh, cool. I learned something new about myself. So regardless if I liked the experience or not, I think it's always cool when you're able to experience something and then learn something more about yourself.
Well, I guess I'm proud of myself too because I didn't really get seasick.
What was that? Something's gonna come out, wasn't it? You look fucking angelic with that light behind your hair.
Thank you.
That was the weakest half
committed. I have a headache. Oh, I know, I have a headache.
Like, cheer. Yeah.
I have a headache. Fine. I think it's from like the rocking.
I'm gonna make you feel real good.
I'm fine. Ew, I have makeup on.
I know, it tastes funny.
And I put face lotion on. And I probably put a little bit of perfume on there.
Yeah, I think I don't like the cruise that much. I mean, it sounds weird saying it, because the cruise is still cool, right? It's like a luxurious experience. But what I'm about it is it feels like a cheap quality Vegas hotel on water. So the novelty about it is just, it's on water.
So then for you then, if it was one of those really expensive cruises, because I think we got like the beginner basic ones.
Yeah.
So if it was one of the top lines with the water slides and like it's like all state-of-the-art stuff, yeah. Then you would enjoy it?
See, that I don't even know because I think the novelty behind a cruise really is it's on water, right?
Yeah.
So if you give me the best ballin' hotel, which I think is probably like the Wynn or something, or the Bellagio, whatever, right? Why don't I just go to the Bellagio? Or why don't I just go to the Wynn?
Yeah.
It's the fact that it's just on water. So to me, it's like saying this, like, hey, check this out. I know the best ramen place. It's so bomb. And it's on a boat. And it's like, well, why don't I just go to the land version and not throw up while I'm eating it?
I'm down with that.
That's what I mean. It's like, I feel like the novelty of a cruise is the fact that it's on water and you get to travel to cool destinations. So maybe that's it. Maybe our destinations are whatever because we're going to Santa Barbara, which is a place we've driven to.
Yeah, we can literally Uber back home.
And Mexico. But if you're from, I guess, like, let's say, Wisconsin. Same thing. And you're like, hey, I've always wanted to check out the coast of California, then I can see it being perceived
worth
in a different way. Yeah.
Yeah.
You really don't feel that good, Mom?
No, I really don't. I have a really bad headache.
What if I give you a wet willy?
No! That's gonna make me want to move away from you really fast. That's gonna give me more of a headache.
What about this?
No.
Does that feel good?
Yeah, that feels good.
What about this?
We made her smile. She saw us. She smiled.
What about that?
Yeah, that feels pretty good.
I really like the new perfume you're wearing.
Oh. We have a difference in nostril sense.
Yeah, we took this online test, and then mine is called Rhytomus, and hers is called Wrongmus.
What's the website where these people can take their test?
DoYouSmellCorrectly.com.
Oh, wow. It's so close to how much you bench. Yeah. That's interesting. There's no such website. He just made
yes,
it up.
Yes, there is.
There's not.
And all I right. love your new perfume.
Right now, we are just waiting for Joe and company to meet us to grub, because we haven't eaten yet. Oh, we did. We got room service in the morning.
I'm excited, though. The place that they Yelp, so everyone in our group is a foodie, and this place is supposed to have some bomb seafood. And seafood isn't something you normally get. So
in Cali.
In Cali, and it's bomb, and it's off the coast, so I'm assuming that it's going to be fresh.
Yeah, so right now, this is where we're sitting. But look at what's right in front of us. Look at this. What a beaut. Well, kind of a beaut because I've been on a boat for like 24 hours and I'm over it. So it's beautiful, but I don't want to get on any one of these. I'm happy to be on this right now.
You know what's weird? When I came off the boat, as soon as I stepped on land, I'm like, dude, this is so solid. It's so solid. It's weird because I was like this for 24 hours.
Oh God.
That this is so weird now.
No, that's how I feel after we've been snorkeling in Hawaii for hours.
Oh yeah.
Snorkeling always fucks me up because we like to snorkel not for like 10 minutes. We snorkel for literally like hours. So I feel that. Thank you. I feel that after we've been snorkeling.
This is one of my favorite cookies in the world, Milano.
Mine's a wafer.
Wafers aren't cookies. My bro?
Yeah.
So we're at a seafood restaurant, and I know you don't necessarily like seafood, but this place is known for seafood.
What was that? Oh, it was like perfect timing, because I know you like seafood.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What do you think you're gonna get? So we got crab cakes, seafood pasta, swordfish, sea bass. No, don't get that. They're known for seafood, babe.
I'm kidding.
Scampi, mahi, mahi, ahi, and salmon. Which one do you think you're gonna get?
This sounds pretty good.
Sea bass?
I've never had swordfish.
Seafood pasta?
I only like salmon raw.
What is it about seafood that you don't really like that much?
The fishy taste.
Oh, really? But sometimes I see you eat seafood. Like, you like ceviche, you like shrimp. Oh, it's because the seafood taste is out?
Yeah, it's very limey. Lemony and limey.
Why don't you pick something that's lemony and limey?
Like a New York steak?
No, like, which one of these guys? Scampi, white wine, lemon.
Yeah, I'm thinking of scampi.
Dash of tomato.
I'm thinking scampi. Maybe like a soup.
Or how about a soup of fried calamari?
That's not a soup.
Are you down to get oysters? Everyone's gonna get oysters here.
Yeah, I'll eat like one. Oh, they have ceviche. Oh, but it's their type of ceviche.
It's the
live with white people.
Can you guys see me taking video?
I'm famous.
Right.
Everybody got really quiet after that.
Yeah.
Did we know it's BS?
Thank you.
You're welcome. Do you want to get mad?
Dark and stormy.
I know what I'm gonna get.
What are you gonna get, Mom Bear?
Blue Hawaiian. The cold combo. The crab meat, ceviche, oysters, clams. I don't really care about clams.
I'll eat them.
Peel any shrimp.
That's awesome. Good job, Mom Bear.
Wonka Wonka.
What's Wonka Wonka mean?
Wonka Wonka.
Take some Dramamine.
I don't even get that.
Just the ship does rock a lot though.
Yeah, it sucks.
I don't get seasick. Well, I haven't gotten seasick, but it does feel crazy. It feels like, whoa, whoa, dude, whoa.
I can't help you. Then I see you move and I'm like, stop.
Oh, you don't feel good, huh?
No.
Does that make you feel better?
Yeah.
I know something that'll make you feel real good.
Oh my god,
what?
I'm so hungry.
I'll give you a massage. I know these special points, so when I hit them on the sides, then it makes it go away.
Fine.
Why, what were you thinking?
I had nothing. I'm not feeling that good.
Oh, sorry, baby.
Fine. Alright, so we're about to have dinner. Mariel, David, Gina, Tiff, Casey, Isaac, Joe, Aunt Christina, and everyone seems like they're doing all right. No one's really getting sick.
I have to eat like this.
Except for me.
They have a rule in this restaurant where you can't have a hat. So I had a hat, and that's what was holding my hair in place. But then, since I don't have a hat, it's gonna come down and I'm gonna end up eating like this.
But this is junior high Bart right now.
Like this? Oh, oh. This.
That's junior high Bart.
No, fifth grade.
That's junior high. Oh my god, is that the knife? Just use it. Oh.
Fifth grade, dude.
That's 16 candles right there.
Long duck.
Long duck dong.
Dong. That's long duck dong. Ha! Calling you out.
Every Asian. This is.
Ooh, every Asian. You were cool. Yeah,
you
were cool.
Never split your hair down the middle.
No, it didn't let me. I couldn't split it.
You're gonna have to both. It was
too gangster,
huh?
No, I think at that time I had like a. It was close to this. It was like a little. Like a Zach Morris. Little. Yeah.
Stud haircut.
The little wave.
He used to have a fro though. He had a fro.
Oh, I had the Dragon
Ball. Like
Ball
Dragon
hair.
Ball.
Like Joe's hair, kind of?
But everywhere.
Yeah, everywhere. Yeah.
What do you mean everywhere?
So everywhere, you know, back in the day, like,
was long range.
Oh.
Yeah, people used to, like, Dragon Ball.
Yeah.
And when it wasn't gelled, it was an afro. So one time I got a perm.
Isaac, miniature Isaac Long Duck Dong.
He looks like Alpha Alpha. He's Alpha Alpha.
He does look like Alpha.
There it is.
The bread's rock hard, right?
It's good though.
The outside's hard, but the inside's soft.
I like that one. The white one.
I like how he says that right in front of the people that work here.
They know what's up. They cracked your teeth before.
Yeah, tell them about the whole cat's eye question. Here
they answer. Oh, so earlier, Joe was asking about the pad thai, because this guy's Thai. So I was like, hey, being a Thai person, what do you think about the pad thai here? And he was like, jumped on the bread. No, but he was like, he's American style. You know what that means.
Which means don't order that shit. It's not good.
It's not authentic.
You're the real MVP.
What is that?
Because I went to the restroom
to poop my life away. And in the time that I was pooping my life away, they went around the table and they asked everyone for what they wanted for their dessert. I unfortunately missed that. Pop over here, the MVP, he already ordered what he thought I would like and he nailed it. So he ordered a creme brulee for me.
I got it because I thought...
Creme brulee?
Creme.
Cream
brulee?
Cream
brulee.
Cream brulee.
Cream brulee.
Cream brulee. You got the cream brulee? The cream brulee. He got the cream brulee for me. And it was dope. I think it's coming. 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 Whoa, what did you order?
The Napoleon, the burnt rhubarb Napoleon.
Make a bomb ass cream brulee.
Oh, shit. For me first?
Oh,
okay. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Tiffany. Woo! Happy birthday to you. Woo! Woo!
How do you feel?
I feel.
Oh. Shut me down! How old are you?
Leave! Get off here!
I know. No.
I mean, we're not that far apart.
No, thank you guys.
How old is she?
Bless up! What the hell? I think we're in Vegas. Look at Byron with the young crowd. Damn, are we in Vegas or what? Okay, so I think we are about to watch a comedy show. Are you looking forward to the comedy show?
I don't know.
Because you're a comedian.
See, that's the thing. Because I'm a comedian, I've done stand-up comedy before. My standards are kind of high. And I'm assuming that any comedian that they hire, just to be real, is probably...
Oh my God, Tiffany's freaking out about something small.
All right, hold on. Hold on. What's going on? Look at her face.
It's a little tan, specific thing, not a regular size.
She loves little things.
Oh yeah.
Sorry, baby. It's because she was freaking out about the little table tip was. But so you're not really expecting anything too crazy, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I'm expecting a lot of doo-doo-sh type jokes because of the crowd. You know, so like usually hire the right type of talent for the crowd, and because the crowd is, you know, they're like almost triple digit type people. They want to hire the.
I see it. All of them. And you know what? I'm not going to talk shit. My mom would probably really enjoy this.
Yeah,
stuff.
I should.
I miss her. All right. Oh, I think the show's going to start. Psych. But yeah, he's not.
He's doing audio tests right now.
I don't know why people started clapping. But yeah, look. Look at the color of the hairs. So we'll see.
Enjoy your day off.
Not to talk shit or anything, but Bart is correct. The demographic is a slight more mature one.
seasoned.
Why are they lowering the music right when you're calling them mature?
They're seasoned.
Seasoned at life.
Well seasoned.
Well seasoned at life.
A little too well done. If you know what you know what I'm saying.
Right for the picking.
See, those are the right for the picking.
He's the one that came up with the tree sub. He's that guy. And he was part of the tree sub.
Oh, that felt good though. I liked it. It felt kind of weird, but I started to enjoy it.
Did you start a fire that night?
I broke a twig. I mean, I broke a branch.
You guys have the surfing turf and
I thought it was a joke. You broke our joke chain.
Oh, I wasn't paying attention.
Sheesh. Are you gonna get down?
Oh my god.
Show's over. What'd you think?
I thought he was really good. You guys should check him out, Derek Cameron. And I thought he's gonna tell a lot of like type jokes, but it was actually really good. He told jokes about politics, about how he feels kids should learn how to laugh more, about how being politically correct stunts your imagination.
About the married life versus life.
Yeah, he has. It was really, really good. I loved it. I thought it was because you know, to me, great comedians are always ones that are philosophers. And anytime that anyone brings up philosophy and their perspective on life, I always feel like that's a good comedian. And I think he did his job really well.
Wow. And I think I like the most thing I like, or one of the best things about this guy, is that he was cracking up the hardest at his own.
Yeah, that part was awesome.
And because he was cracking up so hard, he made you feel good and he made you feel like
The joke didn't even matter at this point because he's just having a good time on stage.
He starts laughing at his joke before he even tells it.
Yeah, yeah, he's laughing mid-joke.
In his mind, you could tell, you can just tell it's so funny in his mind.
It was good. Good job.
Why I can't be lovers, things I can't. How many
selfie.
People were we?
Everyone jump on the back.
The resident DJ's name is DJ Pedro. That's who they were screaming his name. We've never even heard him. We don't even know if he's good. But we're all screaming and chanting his name. This is a fun fucking crowd. Wow. Everyone's gone to bed. I think they're trying to egg Joe to jump in. And let me, just for the record, let me tell you guys, everyone is 100% sober. Oh, except for Ken. He's the only one with the beer, but that's his only beer. I think that's your only drink, right?
Yeah,
everyone else is sober.
Oh, this is... beer I've had not even halfway through it.
This is how crazy we are. Oh, shit. I almost fell. All right, so here's DJ Pedro. But I got to give him my thing.
My drink.
Oh, you can spit it out. It's there. We got to get ID'd.
Everybody got their card, right?
Here we go. DJ Pedro.
You want to ask them?
This is definitely not our demographic.
Why?
I did not grow up in the 70s.
This is what I grew up on.
Stadium! Get it, girl. Get it, girl. Party already started out of here.
You gotta get inside.
People came.
When you want to party,
the chair dancing. The chair dancing.
You're like ashamed of your partying.
When you're just too good for the dance floor.
No, you can't even show your face.
When they ain't ready. When they ain't ready.
Yeah, man.
Dab on them hoes. Dab on them hoes. Look at his shirt.
I'm here to party.
Do your roll. Do your roll. Do your roll. Body roll all the way to the dance floor. Let's see if they can do it. This looks fucking crazy. So, back in our room, and DJ Pedro was not as good as I thought. Did you hear him?
What was wrong with him?
Well, a good DJ. I don't know much about DJing, but I have heard some really good DJs in my lifetime. And the DJs that I've heard, they know how to end a song and introduce a song seamlessly.
Mix.
What does that mean? What is it?
That's the term.
Oh, okay. Do you know how to mix a song? How do you say it? Do you know how to mix one in and one out?
They just know how to mix.
Oh.
That's what mixing means. Mixing means you're able to transition from one song to the other song, like, seamlessly without the beat skipping, without it feeling awkward, without it speeding up or slowing down.
Okay. So, I'm not a DJ expert, but I just know, from my own experience, that a good DJ knows how to mix very well.
Yeah.
Would you agree?
Especially the radio DJs. They go from song to song and they don't skip a beat.
None. It just feels like the producer of the original song intended it to mix into that particular song that they mixed it into.
Yeah, they're really good.
But DJ Pedro, on the other hand, would like stopped abruptly, the whole dance floor stops, and everyone's like, wait, what the fuck, what happened? And we thought, like, the club was gonna close, and then the next song comes up.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, man, DJ Pedro, everyone was chanting your name. Like, everyone on the whole boat has been talking about you. Like, your name is printed, like, on the website, on these flyers. Like,
he's supposed to be hot shit. I saw his watermark on all the TVs.
That's what I'm saying. Like, DJ Pedro, everyone's been praising you. And I, like, we went in there hot. Like, our feet were hot. Like, we couldn't wait to get on the dance floor, tear it up. But DJ Pedro, on the ones and twos, skipping all kinds of beats, making the dance floor stop, move fast, move slow. Like, it was a mess. But luckily, we were with our crew. And as you guys saw, everyone was just having a good old time. We finished karaokeing, then went to check out DJ Pedro, and, like, again, like I mentioned earlier, everyone was sober, but nobody gives a shit about looking cool or trying to be, like, the popular crowd. Like, we're just there to have a good time and be goofy. Like, all of us were a bunch of goofy people that don't give a shit about what's in and what's cool, and we're just like, I want to do what makes my heart happy, and if that's, like, me doing, like, the Cabbage Patch dance that I don't even know if a lot of you know what that is, then I'm just gonna do it. Who cares? Or if they do that dance, what's that called? What's that called?
The Mexican?
No. Well, you know what I'm talking about. That like, if they want to do the chicken dance, they're gonna do the chicken dance. Like, that's what's so cool about our crew.
Yeah.
So, lucky for DJ Pedro, we're a bunch of easygoing cats.
Okay, for DJ Pedro, I'm tired. I just want to go to sleep.
You go to sleep with your hat on?
No. I'm going to take it off. Just my hair's been freaking buck wild these days.
You have a nice set of hair. Like, your hair is so thick, so luscious, so soft, and it's black. It's just black hair.
Is it really
hair.
Soft? I feel
it's
like it's
so
rough.
Soft. Damn.
Isn't it rough?
No, it's really soft. It has a lot of volume, too. You know how many girls would kill for the volume that you have?
Really?
Yes.
Oh, cool.
Oh, my God. Maybe you should let your hair grow out.
And then sell it to a girl?
Yeah. I wasn't your true entrepreneur. I was just thinking, let it grow out. Maybe that hot guy.
Oh, I thought you meant to sell it
to people that need wigs or something.
I never even said anything about selling. I just said you should let your hair grow out.
Just in general?
Yeah, and you're the hot, sexy Asian guy with the sexy hair.
Oh, that's so freaking weird. I can't be that guy. I always see people with long hair, and I'm like, there's no way I could be that guy.
Why? Because you get too hot?
No, it just looks too, like, too bottom lip bitey. You know what I mean? When there's just, like, when the wind's blowing.
Oh, interesting.
I already feel like this is super bottom lip bitey already.
But why do you keep it so long?
Well, I just wanted to change it up, and then I thought you might like it.
Mmm, he did it for me? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm doing for you?
What?
I'm letting my hair grow for you.
Better.
I know, because you're not going to want to have sex with me anymore if it's not long.
Yeah. I already let you do all kinds of weird stuff to your hair.
I know, you're so supportive.
I just want you to have regular hair now, just to make me happy.
And bangs. You really like when I have bangs.
Yes.
And I have bangs because you like my bangs.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I like bangs and a ponytail.
Yeah, I'm sorry I haven't done the ponytail. Since I have wavy hair, I have to straighten it in order for that to happen.
Yeah, you have super curly hair.
It's not curly. Can you guys please in the comments let him know what curly versus wavy is?
You know what's wavy? My hair is wavy.
Oh my god, your hair is so straight. There's not one wave in your hair.
There's freaking curls. Look. Look at these curls. Look at
Show
that.
Me.
Look, that's a curl right
that's
there.
That's straight ass
no,
hair.
Straight as this. It just stands straight.
No.
Or just like this. My hair is curly. You see
that's
that?
Not. Your hair is so...
Look at that wave. Look at this wave. Look.
Your hair is so heavy it creates that wave.
Look, it's a wave.
That's straight as hair, baby.
No, this is a wave.
No, it's not.
So I have wavy hair, you have curly hair.
This is here. No.
You have curly hair.
That's not curly.
You have straight up curly hair.
Oh my god, we need to Google this. I need to Google pictures of curly and pictures of wavy, and you're none of those, and I'm not curly.
Watch. I'm gonna pluck one of your pubic hairs and show how curly it is.
My pubic hairs is I can't remember the last time I saw my pubic hairs.
I know, you never grow it out.
Yeah, I don't remember what it looks like.
You always shave it.
Yeah, I think I've been shaving since, like, or not shaving. You know what I used to do? I was so weird. So my parents never had that talk with me, like the whole puberty talk. Sorry, are you falling asleep? I can cut
yes.
it. I can cut it short.
Do you guys want to hear the puberty talk? Let us know.
Let us know in the comments.
Let us know. If you want to hear the puberty talk, yeah, we'll talk about the puberty.
Okay,
tired.
Fine. I'm going to end it now. This guy's falling asleep. It's past his 10 o'clock curfew.
It's freaking like 1 or something.
I don't know how to have my watch. Sorry if we made you guys yawn. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time.
Good night.